Welcome back. It's Taylor again, and let's keep exploring biology. We began our biology journey studying cells, and then we found that in most multicellular organisms, cells organize into tissues, which come together to form organs, which build body systems, which collectively make an organism. In this lesson, we'll explore a specific body system in humans, the respiratory system. In future lessons, we'll unpack other human organ systems. The respiratory system involves our breathing and makes the oxygen we breathe available to our whole body. Today, we will learn why we breathe, how oxygen travels to the cells of the body, how cells use the oxygen we breathe in, and how the respiratory system gets rid of carbon dioxide waste. If you're following along in your guided notes, pause this video to jot down your current best thinking about why we breathe. Us humans, other mammals, and birds all have similar respiratory systems. The purpose of the respiratory system is to provide oxygen to all the cells in the body and get rid of the carbon dioxide waste produced by those cells. To begin the respiratory system process, we breathe in air, which is just over 20% oxygen, through our nose or mouth down toward the lungs. This process is called inhalation. To inhale, we can make the active decision to breathe in at any time, but this is mostly involuntary, meaning the body does it automatically. To accomplish this, a muscle beneath the lungs called the diaphragm, as well as muscles around the ribs, contract or tighten, making the muscles smaller, allowing the lungs to expand, naturally pulling in air through the nose or mouth. Air moves from the nose or mouth down the trachea, or the windpipe, toward the lungs. The trachea splits into two smaller tubes called bronchi that move into the right and left lungs. Within each lung, each bronchi branches out into even smaller bronchioles. Finally, each small bronchiole ends in a small sac called an alveolus, the plural of which is alveoli. The alveoli are all surrounded by capillaries, or small blood vessels, which carry the oxygen from the lungs to the rest of the body and return the cell's carbon dioxide waste to the lungs. In this way, the cardiovascular system, which contains the heart and blood, collaborates with the respiratory system to transport gases. Why do you think the lungs involve so much branching and splitting up of the air we breathe in? If you're following along in your guided notes, pause this video to jot down your answer to this question. If the lungs were just large hollow sacs, only the relatively small portion of air at the edges of the lungs could interact with the blood vessels to send oxygen to the rest of the body. With these small alveoli, the lungs maximize the surface area between the air we breathe in and the blood vessels, maximizing the amount of oxygen that can be put into the bloodstream with each inhale, and also maximizes the amount of carbon dioxide waste that can be removed with each exhale. At the alveoli, the process of pushing oxygen into the capillaries and taking carbon dioxide out of the capillaries is a gas exchange. At this point, the heart, in another body system, pumps the oxygenated blood out to the entire body. In this way, the respiratory system interacts with all other body systems. When blood reaches its intended cells, the oxygen is given to the cells and the blood takes the cell's waste, carbon dioxide. Cells absolutely require oxygen to do their work. With oxygen and the food we eat, cells form the molecule that our body uses for chemical energy. This process is called cellular respiration. In this series of chemical reactions, cells produce the carbon dioxide waste product that we've mentioned several times. After giving the cells their oxygen and removing their carbon dioxide waste, the deoxygenated blood returns to the alveoli of the lungs. As we noted earlier, In the alveoli, oxygen is dumped into the bloodstream while carbon dioxide is removed. At this point, we breathe out to expel the carbon dioxide and other unneeded gases we originally inhaled from the air from our body. This process is called exhalation. All of these organs of the respiratory system, the nose, trachea, lungs, etc., are of course built of tissues, which are themselves made of cells. Each structure is built in a specific way and with specialized tissues and cells to perform its function. To dive deeper into the lungs, each alveoli is built of three different tissues. The innermost layer is epithelial tissue, followed by supporting structural connective tissue, and finally, a network of capillaries, the small blood vessels that are another type of connective tissue. To conclude, let's check in with our learning objectives. Why do we breathe? How does oxygen travel to the cells of the body? How do cells use the oxygen we breathe in? How does the respiratory system get rid of carbon dioxide waste? If you're following along in your guided notes, pause this video to jot down your thoughts on these questions. We breathe to give our body oxygen, a necessary nutrient for our cells, and to get rid of carbon dioxide, a cellular waste product. Oxygen travels to our cells by first entering the nose or mouth, moving down the trachea, through the bronchi and the bronchioles, and into the alveoli. In the alveoli, oxygen moves into the bloodstream via capillaries and is pumped throughout the body to all its cells by the heart. Cells use the oxygen we breathe in a chemical process called cellular respiration. Cellular respiration transforms oxygen and molecules from the food we eat into a molecule the body uses for energy. This process also produces a waste product of carbon dioxide. The respiratory system gets rid of carbon dioxide waste by first taking the carbon dioxide from the cells, exchanging it for oxygen, into capillaries throughout the body. The carbon dioxide-rich blood moves back to the alveoli. From the alveoli, we breathe out the carbon dioxide. Bravo! We are learning! In future lessons, we'll continue to unpack body systems. Now, go fortify your learning with the practice questions, and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.